try to destroy the church.
Amen.
He already knew that the devil would try to deflate the mission of the church.
Yeah.
He already knew that the devil would try to detour the destiny of the church. So Jesus was emphatic in his instructions to the formation of the church and his membership that no matter what, no matter what, no matter what the enemy may say, no matter what your friends may say, no matter what the pastor may say, no matter what anybody may say, the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church. The gates of hell. And you know, I got down here, the gates of hell is the devil's house. And that's where he lives.
Yes.
That's where he sleeps. But I doubt if the devil will get a chance to sleep. Because the Bible said, when you go to hell, you ain't going to be sleeping down there. It ain't going to be too much sleeping in hell. You're just going to be burning with that eternal fire. But the gates of hell should not prevail against God's church.
Yes.
Well, so as I expound on this lesson, let me share with you by saying, most of us probably are familiar with the Sermon on the Mount.
Yeah.
That's in Matthew.
Yes, yes.
Well, this lesson comes from this, is a follow-up of the Sermon on the Mount. But on the Sermon on the Mount, it says that means Jesus taught on the mountain.
Yeah.
But here, the sermon is on a plain. When you look at verse 17, you will see that and he came down with them and stood in the plain. This is the difference between this sermon. It ties in with Matthew, but and what I liked about it when I looked at that, he came down from the mountain. You know, Jesus likes to keep it plain. He came down on their level.
Yes.
When he was on the mountain, he was speaking down, but now that he's come down from the mountain, and the word of God is so simple, all you got to do is follow him. As you watch this lesson, all you got to do is obey his word.
Yes.
So he came down to the plain of the ground, which is level ground. And there are many similarities between the two sermons, but there are some main differences, most notably that he is not on the mountain, but he's now in a place where they could see him and they could hear him. And he was speaking to the disciples, and he came to a level place to preach. In Luke, he left out the Jewish sections, which would not pertain to the Gentiles. He preached this sermon to the multitudes as well as to his apostles. And this message also applies to us today.
Amen.
So what is this message? Right. Look at verse 46. What did he come down and make it plain for them to hear? Our key scripture today says Jesus turns his focus to obedience, and he rebukes those who claim to be his followers but do not obey his teaching.
That's right.
If you want to follow Jesus, you got to obey the word of God.
Amen.
Jesus was not content with letting his audience ponder his profound thoughts. His teaching is not meant for discussion and debate by academics. You know, we got people in the church want to debate God's word.
Yeah.
Huh? Jesus says to in this sermon that my word is not debatable. I don't care what kind of academia you may be. I don't care how many degrees you have. My word is not debatable in this instance. Instead, Christians should build their entire lives around his teachings and apply them to every facet of their life. If they do not apply them, they won't be able to withstand the pressures of the devil. They will not be able to stand the temptations of the world that we live in. Yeah. Don't you know, if our president didn't have patience, if he didn't have patience, that's why I know he's a Christian.
Amen.
They,
the news media knows maybe trying to say he's something else, but I know he's a Christian because he got too much patience.
Amen.
He's just like Jesus. Sometimes he never says a mumbling word.
Yes.
Well, that's how we have to be.
Amen.
We got too many people in the church, in any church, that get upset when somebody say bad things about
them.
Yeah. Huh? But the President of the United States, I ain't seen him get upset yet.
Amen.
He may get upset when him and Michelle talk before they go to bed. Huh? But when he's in public, he's not upset. So we got to be able to, you got to have the right foundation to withstand the pressures and temptations of this world. The fact that we are part of the church and we live in the path of hurricanes and we notice the weather that the hurricanes will come, we got to be ready.
That's right.
Huh? Yes. You got to have the right foundation. I heard our governor say, we from Florida. Yes. We always prepared for hurricanes.
Yes.
Huh? It don't matter when they come, we in Florida should be prepared.
Yes.
And if you are not getting ready for this hurricane, shame on you because you don't have the right foundation. You need to go out and be buying some water. You need to stock up on your cans, because you don't know where it may be coming. But see, we get complacent.
Amen.
We done looked at the news already. Oh, it ain't coming here. You don't know that.
Right.
You got to be ready.
Right.
Rooted. And know when danger comes. The warnings are there. And so when a storm is approaching, if you don't lose your house and heed the warning, you can surely lose your life.
Yeah.
Such is what Jesus is trying to tell the church in verse 46. He says, why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not what I say? Y'all think about that. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not what I say? Whosoever comes to me and heareth my saying and do them, I will show you to whom he is like. What is he like? I'm going to read that before I go further. He is like a man which built a house and dig deep and laid the foundation on a rock. And when the flood comes, the stream beat vehemently upon that house and could not shake it, for it was founded upon a rock.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus is talking to his followers, but today he's talking to the church.
Yes.
This is church anniversary, right?
Yes.
He said, why do you call me Lord, but you not obey me? Does that not sound like a parent talking to his children or their children?
Yes.
See, Jesus is the Father.
Amen.
Huh? And we are his children.
Yes.
When your children do not obey you, you have a way of getting their attention.
Yes.
Huh? People like being Christians as long as it does not inconvenience them.
Yes.
Huh? They know what the Bible says. Huh? It's so many people know what the Bible said.
Oh, yeah.
But they make too many excuses saying it's too hard. I can't do that. Huh? Jesus says, when you got the right foundation, huh? Ain't nothing too hard for you to do. If you got the right foundation, if you got that solid foundation, you will not waver in your faith unto God's word. When you have a solid foundation, no matter what kind of storm comes in your life, the devil will come at you with all types of problems. The devil will come at you from the north. You got the north wind, the south wind, the east wind, the west wind. Earthquakes can come. Sandstorms can come. No matter what comes at you, when you have a solid foundation, you'll be able to stand.
Yes.
Let me diversify and say, too many of our young people has not gotten the right foundation.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
Too too many of our young people have been exposed to the storms
yes.
of life without being rooted in Christ.
Yes.
What is happening in our society today? What's causing our young people to stray away from the church? Mm-hmm. What's causing them to succumb to the decadence of today's society? Mm-hmm. What causes them to not come and worship God? What causes them to come into the church and then they leave the church and never to come back because they don't have a solid foundation? Amen? Maybe it's because they get the best things in life too early in life. Y'all missed that? We had to wait. You know when I got my first car? 19. When do kids get their first car now?
16.
Well, 15, they can't drive. But still, they got it waiting on them. Huh? Some people have it waiting on them. They turn in 16, they birth, well, Christmas in December, and their birthday in March. Well, they get a car in December, and it's right there in March when they get their license. But when you in Jesus, huh? You got to wait on your blessings.
All right.
Huh? He's not going to give you your blessing before your time.
Amen.
Huh? Well. Is it because they wear the finest of clothes? Is it because we send them to school? Watch this. But we don't make sure they get
to school.
Oh,
y'all missed it. Let me talk. We send them to school. But we do not give them the right foundation to make sure that they're getting out of school. Well, we sending them to school to get. Go to school. You better come back home straight from school. But that's all you teaching them. To go to school and come back from school. What are they learning or what you're doing in the time that they left and the time they come back? They don't have the right solid foundation. We bring them to church hoping they get religion. Y'all missed that one, huh? We hope they get religion. But we don't teach them that they need to be grounded and rooted in Jesus. The church nor the school is responsible to give our children the foundation that they need. It must be given to them at home. What Jesus is saying, church, is that you need to have a solid foundation.
Yes,
foundations do matter. And so as we look at this story, it says two men were building a house. One was careful to push away the faulty earth and find a rock to build his house upon. When the rains came, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and it beat upon that house. But the house did not fall.
Amen.
Because the house had the right contract.
Yes.
The house was built upon a rock.
Yes.
But then there was a man who did not listen.
Well,
there was a man who did not heed to the warning of the foundational teacher and his Jesus. There was a man that did not live to the principles of God's word, now the principles of building his house.
Yeah.
He did not dig deep enough. I come by to let you know you got to dig deep to get down into Jesus. It's something about you on the inside that want to get a little deeper in Jesus. And when you get deeper in Jesus, you will be rooted in a rock, and that rock is Jesus.
Yes.
He did not want to dig deep.
Yes.
He built his house on top of the sand.
Yes.
These men may have had the same
house plants. They might have used the same material from the same